Hey guys, what's up? It's Nikki. How are y'all doing? Happy Saturday evening. So, I'm sorry I haven't been around that much on Facebook today, but it's because I've been running around like a mad woman. So, I'm feeling amazing. I have really not had this much energy in a long time. I feel a definite difference in mental clarity. I feel like my eyes are more open. I don't know if that makes sense to anyone out there, but I literally feel like my eyes are open wider, like I can see clearer, like it's fresh. I don't know, like if you ever like splash like cool water in your eyes and you just have like a sense of like you can almost like see things more clearly. So last night John and I didn't go to bed till like 1 o'clock in the morning. Sorry, but we were just chilling, having a good time. And we woke up, so Saturdays was like usually the day that I would sleep in, and like we switch, right? So everybody gets a day to sleep in on the weekend. And like guys, like legit, I could sleep in till like 11 o'clock if I wanted to. I love sleeping. So we were up till 1 o'clock in the morning last night, and I was like, oh God, this is gonna be really, really difficult to get up tomorrow morning. And I woke up naturally before 8 o'clock. And I was like up, I was up, and I wasn't dragging. I wasn't like, oh God, I gotta get out of bed, you know, because I hear, you know, one of the kids is up. I just woke up and I laid in bed for a while because I was like, I don't know what to do. It was insane. And John woke up at the same time. He was like, I'm totally awake. Like, I'm cool. Let's get up and just start going with our day. I went through like 8 loads of laundry, you guys, and I folded them, and then I went and decided that I needed to switch out Maddox's drawers, so I put away all of his clothes that he was getting that were getting too small for him, pulled out of storage all of his new clothes, right, which are Xander's hand-me-downs, and then rearranged everything on the first level of the house. Like, it's insane, and I meal prepped, okay? Because I didn't do that yesterday. So I meal prep for today too. And my parents are in town and the kids had a t-ball game and I got John's Father's Day present. I hope he doesn't watch this video right now. Insane amount of energy. So yeah, that's how I'm feeling. I'm feeling amazing. Oh, and PS, I'm down 2 pounds. Yeah, I'm down 2 pounds now and John's down 8 pounds. He lost 8 pounds in 5 days. That's insane. So we're feeling amazing. The food was fantastic today. It was really good. A lot of it was repeats from earlier in this week. So like microgreen salads, stir-fried veggies. Tonight I made zucchini cashew soup in a food processor, which was definitely a first for me. Like I made my own soup. That's freaking nuts. Oh, and PS, I did learn too that there's a fill line on a food processor. And if you go over top of that fill line, it comes out the bottom. So a couple pages of my Ultimate Reset book are kind of destroyed right now, but hey, live and learn. So it goes. So yeah, zucchini cashew soup and like a roasted root medley, which is amazing. It was like sweet potato, carrot, beets and onions with a little EVOO and Himalayan salt. And it was like 400 in the oven for 40 minutes. Like write that one down, guys. It is an amazing side dish. It is something that I will take away from the reset. I will definitely make that as a side. So definitely take that one. It was amazing. What else do I get asked a lot? I guess, am I tired? No. No, I have energy for days. It's really incredible. Do I think I can make it through this? Yeah, abso-freaking-lutely. I know I can make it through this. It's incredible. I think we're just at the point where it turns, and I'm really like starting to like physically see and feel the results. So I'm gonna have to do my like our before and afters. Maybe I'll do like our 7-day before and afters. Would you guys want to see that? Do you want to see like 7-day progress photos, or would you rather see 21 days? So like the beginning and the end. Let me know in the comments below. Was no caffeine hard? Okay, so for me, Michelle, it wasn't, but I didn't drink coffee before this anyway, so I'm really a poor judge of character there. John drank a lot of coffee, and to be like God's honest truth, he still drinks coffee. He does. And he still lost 8 pounds in 5 days. He cut down the amount of coffee that he's drinking, but he still has coffee now and then. And hey, you know, like the one cool thing that I learned going into this, I was watching a video that Carl Daikeler and his wife Isabel did, and they're talking about the reset, and they're like, this is your reset, okay? So if there is something, you know, that you need to do to get through it, like, right, you have to have like an extra snack or something because you're starving, like, and you choose to have like an apple or some almonds or something, like, so be it. Like, it's your reset. It's, you're still gonna come out better on the other end, right? So yeah, he still drinks the coffee, but he's still, like, the acidic level of his body is still so much decreased because he's not drinking nearly as much as he used to. Plus, his diet has changed, and I mean, like, legit, he lost 8 pounds in 5 days, not exercising, not a lick of exercise, just, it's strictly the diet. It's incredible. Yeah, so that's kind of the answer on the caffeine. So you just kind of take it as you go. They also recommend that you try and like wean off it as you go into the reset. So you could try that if it's something that you're going to try out. And just kind of see how your body responds, because nobody wants you to be absolutely miserable, right? Like, that's not the whole purpose of this. The purpose of this is to become, you know, more healthy. So, and you will be, even if you cut down on that and then start to like put the really awesome food into your body. So I'm looking forward to the last 2 weeks of this. Excited and kind of nervous too for week two. Week two is detox week. I know, it is crazy, Michelle. 8 pounds. I couldn't believe it. I told him yesterday, guys, honestly. He came home last night and he walked like into the garage and I was like, you look thinner. And I asked him to weigh himself again this morning because I had asked him like yesterday, I think in yesterday's confessional, said he was down like four pounds. Well, he'd weighed himself like after dinner, like at the end of the night, not in the beginning of the morning, which is when you should weigh yourself. And that's when he took his original weight. So I asked him to do it again this morning whenever he woke up. And that's when it was 8 pounds, 8 pounds in 5 days. I mean, it, right there, I mean, last night was a crazy craving night for me too. My parents are in town visiting. And the kids wanted to have a pizza party with them. Oh man. So we ordered our favorite pizza and literally had to like take it from the delivery man and smell its sweet goodness, knowing that I would not be able to chew on that cheese. And you know, John even felt it too. And I was like, listen here, let's make a deal. Let's eat all of our dinner first. And if we're still hungry, then you can have a piece of pizza. And both of us ate our food and we're like, we're fine. It was just like, you're just hungry for food. You're just hungry for food. It's not so much like, it's not about the pizza. And then I kind of looked at it, and after it had sat out for a while and it had like dried up and it still kind of looked the same, I was like, oh man, like, no, don't really want that in my body right now. Like, will I eat pizza again? Yeah, absolutely. But just in the grand scheme, I was like, I don't need it. I just needed to eat. So I think that's something that's like kind of important too. So, but last night, like, I was definitely struggled looking at it and just having it around here, and you know, I was kind of afraid I would like sleepwalk downstairs into the refrigerator in the middle of the night and heat up a piece. Milk and cereal are becoming like less distant in my mind, though. I still visit the cereal aisle every time I'm in the store just to look at sweet, beautiful cereal, because I definitely have a love for it. So we'll see. So the last 2 weeks are totally vegan, so we're getting ready to transition into that and into week two detox. So tomorrow morning my Peapod order arrives. That's what I did today. Remember I told you yesterday I reserve a spot for Peapod just by putting like $60 worth of diapers into the shopping cart, and then I can check out and therefore reserve the spot. So today I went in and just, you know, entered in the whole shopping list, everything we would need for week two. And my mother-in-law is coming into town tomorrow to stay with us for a while. So it's going to be cool. I think she's going to eat on this plan with us too, just to see what happens. So that should be really fun. So it's going to be here between 9 and 11. So maybe I'll just do a quick video for you guys then too, and just show you what I ordered from the shopping list that's provided for me, right? I didn't make any of this stuff up, for the second week and the detox week. So that's what's going on. I hope you guys all had an awesome, awesome Saturday. It was beautiful here in Virginia. So been enjoying it. And I hope you guys all have a really awesome Father's Day tomorrow. Enjoy yourselves. Have fun. I'll see you back here again at 8:20. All right. Talk to you guys soon. Thanks for tuning in.